Once again, Ember could feel eyes watching. Ember approached the Forlorn, but felt it was different. They said, I know what I need to do, what I need to feel. I don't want to be helped. Ember could not help. Not all problems were puzzles to be solved. Ember uncovered a journal entry. Dusk brings the longest shadows. The lanthorn comforts me. Soft melodies from home. The wild things listen. Yellow eyes in graying trees. Where we are. I've been walking forever, lost in the marsh. The two travelers were talking quietly. Yeah, I got so lost in the marsh, you know? Why go anywhere else if it's safe here? Yeah, never having to worry again. The birds scare me though. The guards squawked. Stand back, don't come any closer. The guard was protecting a path down between the rocks. Nothing down there but sadness and turning forlorn. Go see the Forest King. He'll set you straight. The Forest King showed me the way. You'll see there's no need to keep going. He'll make a bird of you. Go get your feathers. crossroads gate was locked. It was worth trying, but it didn't fit in the lock. The guard joked. Another scrawny ember from the forest. And with a bag looking all nicely and shiny. Both guards started looking at Ember with a deathly stare. The guard leered. The forest king would like you, little scruff. Yes, come a little closer. Let us see what's in that bag. We guard the door to the Forest King. Oh yes, we decide who gets to see the king. The Forest King will want to see you. Yes, yes, come this way. Change your mind, little scruff? Don't keep the Forest King waiting. The Forest King... Yes, yes, come this way. Feeling of foreboding overcame Ember. Ember was terrified but tried not to show it. The giant bird spoke softly. Another little Ember. Speak, little one. Do not fear. The bird is a friend. Ember wanted to feel safe. Oh, little Ember, birds won't hurt you. Birds will take another under our wing. Stay safe in the nest, you'll never turn forlorn. Ember was still afraid. Is it the night that scares you, little one? See, night is gone. Day is here. Birds will make the world less frightening. It wasn't only the night that frightened Ember. The bird grew frustrated. Do not become like other Embers, trying and failing and turning forlorn. Birds will protect you from false hope. The Forest King spoke so gently to Ember. Perhaps they could rest here for a while. It was hard to know what else to say. Clever little Ember. You will stay. You will not turn forlorn. Search for hope no more. Now take this feather. feather means Embo is one of us now. Birds keep little ones safe. Birds should never leave the nest. The guards seem pleased. Clever Scruff sticking with us. I can hold that bag for you. Leave him alone. They're one of us now. Yeah, one of us. And we all share bags and things. The stranger wanted Ember's attention, being careful not to speak too loudly. You should get away from here while you still can. You can't trust the birds. I've heard there's another campfire in the marsh. Well, that's where I'm going if I can find a way down. The travelers had disappeared. Their campfire remained. The ashes were still warm. Bear tracks lay in the cinders. The guards squawked. Stand back, don't come any closer. Nothing down there but sadness and turning forlorn. Go see the Forest King. He'll set you straight. Got your first feather, I see. Best prove yourself, Scruff. Stand watch here. Promise you won't let anyone pass. Ember didn't like deceiving the birds. But what choice did they have? They couldn't rest in that place forever. They had to keep going. This forlorn was not the same as the others. The forlorn whispered softly, I know what I need, but I am not ready. I may never be ready. The future is yours, stranger, but mine is mine. Ember left the forlorn with their thoughts. The time wasn't right, perhaps would never be. Hidden away was a scrap of journal. There are memories here, bound in rock. I hear their voices echo in the ancient stone. I find footprints by the cinders, a makeshift camp. Ember hurried away from the birds. The mist hung close to Ember, hiding them. The Forest King seemed frightened, the birds cruel. Ember would rather risk turning forlorn than become like them. Ahead there would be others to help, and maybe a way to move on. Thank you. Ember found a scrap of journal. I heard them coming. The snap of a twig, a flutter of birds. A figure dashing through the undergrowth. Another like me? Travelers seem distressed. I'm sure it's fine. They'll be okay. But it's been a while since... It's my fault. Traveler whispered quietly, "No matter where I go, I always end up here. No matter where I go, always here." It looked like a map, but pieces were missing. Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Another face at last. A catcher of fish resting by a pond. We work together, silk and tar and aching fingers. My boat floats once more, though I almost wish to stay. The fog was so blinding, Ember was turned around. The piece formed a new route. It was the same place as before, but how? In a haze, they said, "You're just like me now, going round and round and round and never escaping." An eerie scene, like a moment frozen in time. Inside was a secret diary entry. Pink, orange, red, brown, leaves gently dancing to the ground. Crunch, crackle, lovely sound, fall into a giant mound. Gradually, more of the map was revealed. A section of bridge had somehow been ripped from its foundations. It was like the map had been broken on purpose. The mist revealed a secret place. Was it hidden on purpose? The stranger spoke. You know, part of me didn't want to be found. I said some things I shouldn't have. And now I'm lost, and it's too late. The skeleton looked peaceful. Held tightly in its hand was a red feather. The statue spoke, just as it once moved the heart of the forlorn. The instrument you now hold has the power to move the world around you, another before you took great effort to hide it deep within this riddle. The lanthorn began to glow. Message was inside. The mist is thick. One way blurs into another. Where do I end? Where does the world begin? I cannot see far enough to tell. Ember found a secret note from the Wanderer. Something beckons. This place is not home. I trace the map in my head, recite the old myths. I have to move on. There was one last place to reach on the map. Ember found a lost message. The smell of hot broth and hearty stew wafts across the swamp. By the cook's pot, I meet another. They are on their own path, but we promise to meet again. Ember felt a great relief to be out of the mist. Ember didn't mind getting muddy. The slide was such fun. A sleeping pig. Trotters in the air. They looked happy. The plant looked like it could take a hand off, and it was in Ember's way. The fruit was giving off a sickly sweet smell. The plant looked like it could take a hand off, and it was in Ember's way. The plant looked like it could take, and it was in Ember's way. Ember chuckled. The dangerous plant was no match for a hungry piggy. Thank you. A hideous odor filled the air. And suddenly, the reason was obvious. The pig inhaled a giant snort of air. Wait, what's that delicious smell? Ember shuffled nervously. Other embers fed me treats. But then stopped. You feed me now. It was junk. Maybe the pig would eat some junk. The pig chewed, a light grew in its belly. Surprising, a little sparky, but tingly in belly. But what I want is something more fruity. The pig would eat anything. Ember just needed to find more. The skull was disgusting. Perhaps the pig would like it. Ember came upon another campfire lost in the wilderness. It looked long cold, but ready to be lit. The ghost said, "Speak and I will listen." This is the Hollow Marsh. Here hope was consumed before it could flourish. You must not lose hope, or you too will turn forlorn. Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind. There are others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. Down steps to your east, travel the path south, watching a pig grow unhappy, a forlorn, lost hope. Thank you. Through the mist, Ember could feel they were being watched. The stranger knew they had to move on. The path behind was forever closed. They had no choice, and yet they hesitated. They tried so hard to see it all. To leave now seemed unbearable. The stranger stared past Embel. I'm almost ready. Let me sit a little longer. I will catch up. I promise. Inside was a scrap of journal. In the orchard, I meet the stranger from the cook's fire, a stranger no longer. Together, we fill their satchel, food and memories for the road ahead. The stranger said excitedly, I've not heard a lanthorn play in a long time. Magical sound a lanthorn makes. Your whole body moves. Let me tell you, I plays a good lanthorn. The orchard gate was locked and needed a key. It was worth trying, but it didn't fit in the lock. Wanderer's Diary. An ancient throne sits empty. No one remains to guide or protect, but we do not mind. My companion shelters with me now. We cannot help those left behind. Ember found the Wanderer's Diary. We stop by the warmth of another campfire. The guardian spirit provokes us, asks what we hope to resolve. I do not understand the question. My companion is silent. The stranger had come so very far. They felt the air beneath them, the distance ever widening. It was such a long way down. A resolve stirred within the stranger. Just a few more steps. It can't be much further.
What is this? Not food. Bring me food.
And with each thing it ate, the light grew even brighter.
Crunchy, embery. Not much meat, bit too bony. But what I want is something more fruity.
Perhaps if Ember could satisfy the pig, they might be more helpful.
Thank you.
This was the last thing Ember could find to offer. Fruity, fresh, but tastes a lot like mud. But what I want is... The pig's stomach made an almighty sound. Ember chuckled with relief at the large creature they had been so afraid of. The pig had vanished, but something moved beneath the surface. In a muddy pond, Ember thought the pig looked a lot less imposing. The pig shouted joyously. The water feels so good on the skin. Join me, morsel! The pig seemed happy, but Ember wasn't getting too close. Why do I consume whatever people put in front of me? I need some true nourishment, but there's none left here. But so much cooler in this muddy pond, I can finally think. Thank you, morsel. Ember thought about the pig. Fed to burst it cheerily, the stranger said. Don't say much, little friend, do you? You remind me of one of those golem statues. Stood there, mouth open. I like you. A stone golem frozen in the lake, a relic from a forgotten time. Ember watched as the helpful piggy cleared the path. Ember
member uncovered a journal entry. Snotty piggy, simple piggy, so easily teased with fruit. They are no help until they are fed. A few grow fat, wobbling on their trotters. The stranger couldn't take on more. Time to grow had passed. The stranger stretched their limbs. Perhaps it is not too late after all. Hidden away was a scrap of journal. Hands encircled around the evening fire, merry lanthorn tunes, singing out the promises of old. Will home be as we remember? The pot had turned cold. The fire had died. Nothing the cook made felt good enough. Anyway.
endlessly stirring the same tasteless pot. Couldn't focus, sleepwalking through the days. Aimed inwards was a swirl of thoughts. In the eye of the storm, a fragile flicker. They wanted to serve something perfect. The praise of others was hollow. Cook felt numb and hurt all at once. Spoke softly. Oh, hello, little one. I didn't see you. I must have lost myself for a moment. It's supposed to be my new soup recipe. But it's not ready. It's not done. A wonderful smell wafted towards Ember. You look starving, poor thing. Have a little taste, but it's not right yet. The most beautiful thing Ember had ever tasted. I know. It's got no flavor, nothing special. Ember wished the cook would believe them. Oh, I'd forgotten how good it feels feeding folk. But it's not ready. There's no need to pretend just to make me feel better. The cook stirred their soup, looking at Ember, looking at the pot, stirring, thinking. Soon, maybe. Oh, I used to love this. Just want to be good at it. But it feels like I'm making the same things over and over. Nothing has flavor. I'm stuck. If you know what you want, I can try. But I really need some better ingredients. Something from the orchard could have worked. If it was still standing. Oh! The cook struggled to hold back their emotions. Pigs have gotten in me orchard. Planted every sapling I did. All me hard work ruined. Take the key and have a look yourself. I can't bear to. See if anything is left, but I promise you, there won't be.
The stranger was afraid. They couldn't see what lay ahead. Ember saw their own fear reflected in the stranger. The darkness hungered for them all. Little Ember spoke hesitantly. How do you continue, never knowing if we'll reach the end? Cheerily, the stranger said. Don't say much, little friend, do you? Remind me of one of those golems. Stood there, mouth open. I like you. The orchard gate was locked and needed a key. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. The cook was right. The pigs had destroyed everything. Thank you. pig devoured the fruit with careless abandon.
Thank you.
the stranger couldn't face themself. They'd never meant any harm. Just hurt to be outshone. It had been easier just to turn aside. The stranger searched Ember's face. Is there hope for me, do you think? Will I make it? Ember found a scrap of journal. The lanthorn wards off ghosts and fear. It shapes the world as we wish it. I urge my companion to rest, but still they stare into the fire. The stranger closed their eyes and let the fog overwhelm them. Soft, gentle fog. It held them like a vice. The mist could not be pushed, would not be fanned away. The stranger spoke. The fog didn't choose me, it just was. I hope it never closes on you, friend. The frog seemed nervous, but also relieved to see Ember. They told Ember that the birds had let all the pigs into the orchard. And that the pigs had eaten everything. All whilst the birds watched and laughed. Except one precious thing the frog had managed to keep safe. The frog offered the lotus seeds to Ember. They pleaded for Ember to take the lotus seeds to their old friend, the cook, as the frog knew how important good ingredients were in hard times. Hidden inside was the Wanderer's journal. Our feet are weary, the hours long. There will be much to do when we arrive. I tell my companion of those waiting at home. They do not seem to know what to say. Inside was a secret diary entry. The satchel is almost bare, our supplies exhausted. The taste of a good meal is not easily forgotten, but it slipped my mind to thank the cook. The ghost said, "Speak and I will listen." East by wooden bridges, on a lonely plinth, a forlorn sits in sorrow. With courage, the ember said, "We should be more careful of each other." Gently, the stranger said, "Love survives us all in the end." The ember spoke hesitantly. "Nothing is endless." The ember whispered, "It's so long since I last felt heard." With love, the stranger said, "I needed a friend." "Thank you." Softly, the ember said, "Most people are unhappy sometimes, don't you think?" Hello there. I can't believe... Where did you... I've never cooked with lotus seeds before. Ember felt happy seeing the cook suddenly so full of purpose. What a lovely surprise. What a lovely surprise. Please try some. It's not much, but there's plenty to go around. Help yourself. Be well, little one. And do remember me if you are ever hungry. Back so soon? It takes a long time to grow it. Some of the leaves are poisonous, so that's something. Till we meet again. Back so soon? You ever want to feel good about your cooking, feed a piggy. They always ask for more. Makes you feel loved, but then later you see them eating small chews. We call them apples, but I don't think they are apples.
They look a bit wrong. They taste, but if you boil them, then they taste wrong in a different way. Till we meet again. The pig was joyous. What is this, morsel? My insides feel as refreshed as my outsides. I did not dream such food was possible. We will plant a garden of treats. We will grow and eat like piggy kings. Compliments to the chef. A lost message was inside. Our music crafts our path, bridging over any we pass. My companion's hand clutches mine. We dart like fireflies through the swamp. So soon? Thank you for everything. Take this and be well, little one. The pig was my insides feel I did not dream we will plant a compliment to the chef. So soon? Thank you for everything. Take this and be well, little one.
Ember found a secret note from the Wanderer. A memory laps at the edge of my dreams. A time before the water, someone I wished to stay for. We must hurry home. Ember found a lost message. To see hope fade in those you care for. The harder I squeeze, the quicker it slips away. The stranger puzzled over their journey. Steps felt effortless. They twisted by unseen. Gratefully, the stranger said, "Friend, thank you. We all help each other along the path." Ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead." "You have done well to get this far, little one. I will clear the path ahead for you." "You have seen another watching over you. They know the secrets of this place. Seek them out